Hey there, everyone, it's Ivo once again. Welcome back for another movie review. And today I'm going to review a martial arts film, and that's Mission of Justice, which it came out in 1992, was the release of direct to video, and stars Jeff Wincott and Bridget Nielsen, and of course, Matthias Hughes, guest stars Matthias Hughes, Cindy Pass, Karen Shepard, Christopher Kriezat, Luca Berkovici, Tom Wood, James Liu, and Billy Sly Williams, and directed by Steve Barnett, and written by George Saunders, John Bryant, and uncredited story by Pierre David. And of course, I got this DVD today. I do really wish that I could got the Blu-ray. I wish this movie would be released on Blu-ray. Yes, Germany has released this film, but I was unable to get it. I only got it on. I was unavailable to get it. I only could got it on eBay. The DVD, no one has it from the Germany Blu-ray. I wish that the UK or at least the US would release this film on Blu-ray and give it a free, you know, free region. I wish it would be free region. I really do wish this would be free region, but sadly, this never was free region. So I got it today, the DVD. And this is one of my favorite movies of all time that I really love, that I enjoy. It's a martial arts film. And Jeff Wincott is actually one of the most underrated action stars ever, and he's actually a martial artist. He's a black belt in Taekwondo, and he's a martial artist. And during this film, he never did train a stick fighting, and I think it's kind of Indonesian martial sports, you know, martial arts sports. You know, but yeah, he never trained. Never knew how to use. You know, he never was trained in a stick fighting. So he never studied the style of stick fighting. But his training consisted of a single 45-minute session with his Krima master Burton Richardson. You know, which Burton Richardson was his trainer, and the five scenes that you see were done for real. Realistic, and the movie talks about a cop without a patch. Yeah, that's how I call it. Out of control, out of uniform, out of control. A cop without a patch. I'll just call this film a cop without a patch. That's just me, you know. But Jeff Wincott plays Kurt Harris. I think he's in LA, he's a cop, and that's a good one, you know, in a uniform, he's a cop, he's chasing scumbags and criminals, and he doesn't get along with his sergeant Duncan, played by Christopher Chris, and he doesn't get along with him. And after he arrests a man who was beating his wife, and it turns out that man is actually a snitch, and his sergeant gets pissed, you know, and also there's like three guys are actually robbing this liquor store, and of course Kurt Harris with his partner, Lynn Steele, they try to prevent the robbery, and you have a great fight scenes, and it turns out that one of the members, you know, one of the robbers runs away, but of course, Kurt chases him, but the man gets caught by some guy who calls himself a peacemaker. It turns out there's actually a facility called Mission of Justice, which is actually an institute, which is actually an institute led by Dr. Rachel Larkin, played by Bridget Nielsen. And she wants to become a mayor in LA, and she gets elected. She wants to become a mayor in LA, and she wants to get elected to become a mayor, and she created a group, which they're actually called peacemakers, who are provided for peace on the streets, you know. And and of course, Kirk Harris does not like that, you know, because it goes on the news, a peacekeeper prevented a robbery, you know, and Sergeant Duncan gets pissed on Kirk Harris. And so when he let that snitch go, you know, that snitch goes and kills his wife, and Kirk Harris goes and beats him back. And now it turns out something else, you know. He goes and arrests him, you know, and still stab him by beating him. And because he beats the suspect, you know, his sergeant suspend him for 2 weeks without any payment, you know. And and of course that criminal is laughing and cut with his fucking elbow direct kicks him right in the show, and we see all blood, you know. And he also punches his superior officer, and he gets fired, and he quit the force. So he gets to his friend Cedric, played by Tony Burton from Rocky. Tony Burton was in this movie after he did all the 5 Rocky movies, you know. Tony Burton was this movie, and he played Cedric, I think it was Cedric Williams in this movie. He played Cedric, and because Cedric and Kurt are actually friends, you know, Kurt goes to train with him, and of course Cedric tells him, of course, Kurt tells that he quit the force, and Cedric decides, you know, because the young, you know, young people think that boxing is actually old sport, so he could become a teacher and teach them martial arts. And of course, Kurt says, no, I'm gonna get by, you know. Cedric asks him, do you have money? Yeah, don't worry, everything about it. And of course, Cedric does not get along with Mission Justice, doesn't get along with Rachel Larkin, and because Rachel, you know, she wants that he's part of family, but he doesn't agree with how Larkin's methods, you know. He doesn't agree how Larkin is actually run that place. And when Titus shows up, and Rachel and Titus and her man shows up, you know, in the ring, there's a bloody match between Titus and Cedric, and Titus breaks Cedric's both arms and kills him, you know. Actually, Rachel kills him, she slits his neck, you know, with two knives, you know. And yeah, so that's what actually happened, you know. She slashes his neck, and when Kurt finds out, you know, that his friend's been killed, he's very upset. And when he goes back to the gym, he found a flower, and of course his ex-partner Lynn still tells him what happened, you know. She tells him that that his friend was killed. It looked like a robbery, and his neck was slashed, and of course when Kurt decides to investigate the murder himself, you know, the lead brings him to Mission of Justice, to Peacemakers, and he decides to become peacekeeper. He decides to become a peacekeeper. He decides to become a peacemaker, and he joins Dr. Larkin's session of peacekeepers of Mission of Justice. And we see tons of martial artists, you know. He goes to this gauntlet and kicks everyone's ass, you know. He becomes a peacekeeper, but more he investigates, you know, he finds that there's something fishy between Dr. Rachel Larkin and the sessions that they do have. And when it becomes all personal, you know, when everything becomes personal, and Rachel Larkin finds out that he was friends with Cedric and that he's actually a spy, she goes and kills her man goes and kill his superior officer, Sergeant Duncan, and framed Harris for his murder. And of course she also goes and kills Nanny from Jimmy, because Jimmy saw her killing Cedric. And now Jimmy and Kurt are on both in the same boat, and they decide to help each other. But of course Jimmy gets kidnapped, and Kurt gets framed, you know, for the murder. But the only person that helps him is actually his ex-partner Lynn Steele, played by Karen Shepard. And she's the only one that helps him out. And they go to the mission, and there's a few martial artists, and on the end he finds the murder, and that's Titus, played by Matthias Hughes, with Kurt Harris. And Kurt on the end defeats Titus, you know, and Lynn puts a videotape which proves that Dr. Rachel Larkin did kill people, you know, but she gets arrested in the end. Kurt doesn't kill her, he arrests her, you know. And the movie then, of course, ends. And it's a fast-paced, it's a martial artist film. And I really enjoy it. The fight scenes are great. They are realistic. Are done for real. They're all done for real. The gauntlet is actually the best scene. I think it's at least 10 minutes long. Or less. I think it was 5 minutes. But the stick fighting was really badass, you know. The stick fighting, you know, when Kurt Harris goes and he makes like those flip sides, you know, and he goes and kicks I at least counted an 18 attackers with a stick fighting, and he kicked like a Bruce Lee, he kicked all of them, you know. That's the best scene, great choreographed, realistic, the fights are for real. It was great choreographed, you know, that was real, for real. That wasn't like, oh, they didn't touch each other. It was done for real. The fight scenes were done for real. My favorite scene will be the garage when Kurt and another peacemaker and Jimmy, they go in this mechanic shop, you know, in mechanic workshop. And they fight those bad guys, and like there's this guy with a shotgun tries to kill with two barrel shotgun tries to kill Kurt Harris, and the other one runs with a machete, and Kurt Harris like a pure badass, you know, shoots him, and the guy gets killed, you know, he falls down, which is a badass scene. And the park in the mechanic workshop is actually the best fight scenes I have ever seen, the best fight scenes. And that was pretty awesome. I mean, the fight scenes in this movie are great. And Jeff Wincott kicks a lot of ass in this movie. It's really great, you know. He goes and kicks everyone ass. He's a pure badass, you know. This movie is a badass film. He goes and kicks everyone ass. Of course, at one point, they wanted Cynthia Rothrock back, because this is supposed to be Martial Law 3, because in the first movie, 1990, Cynthia Rothrock and Chad McQueen started together, which I like that film. But then the sequel, Chad McQueen wasn't interested to return with his character, so Jeff Wincott pulled back for character Sean Thompson, which he came back. And this is supposed to be the third movie, but Cynthia Rothrock was not interested. She did instead Tiger Claw 3, which I think was kind of terrible, a bad movie. Kind of don't remember that much, but I kind of hated that film. But Cynthia Rothrock pulled off, and thank God she was in this movie. Karen Shepard, another martial artist, she replaced her. And also Cindy Pass. And Cindy Pass, she was in Bounty Tracker with Cindy Pass and Matthias Hughes, they both played, they were both in Bounty Tracker the same year, you know, with Lorenzo Lamas. And another film that I enjoy, that movie I do have on VHS. I used to have on VHS, but I don't have the VHS anymore, sadly. Matthias Hughes, you know, we have actually a great cast. I mean, Jeff Wincott is great as Kurt Harris. The fight scenes, the final fight scene between Matthias Hughes and Kurt Harris is realistic or bloody. Or I love the fight scene between Cindy Pass and Karen Shepard. Karen Shepard goes on there like a pure badass she is and kicks her right in the face, you know. When Kurt Harris uses his spin kicks, you know, better than Van Damme. You know, but I miss this kind of movies and I wish we could get. I really do wish that we could got this movie on Blu-ray. This movie deserves to get released on Blu-ray. Yes, Jeff Wincott did Martial Outlaw, I think was another movie a year later. Not a fan of the film, I only saw it once, I was not a fan of that film. My only favorite movie is actually Mission of Justice. Not Martial Law 2, Mission Justice is actually my favorite. And I think it's underrated, you know. But yeah, the fight scenes, the stick fighting is great. The gauntlet scenes is the best. Richard Nielsen is the best of the film. Matthias Hughes, he was in Kickboxer 2. Asnir Vargas, he was in No Retreat, No Surrender 2. Another villain. Matthias Hughes played a lot of villains. I think it was another film. Iron Fist, something like that. He was a villain. But I read it somewhere that Matthias Hughes in real life is actually a very nice guy. At least that's what I read it. But he's actually a very nice guy. And yeah, that's Matthias Hughes. Richard Nielsen did a good job. She did a great job. Jeff Wincott is the best of the film. Mission Justice. You know, I really do love this film. I really do enjoy this film. I really wish. I mean, the gauntlet scene is a pure badass. You know, this is actually a badass scene. I wish that someone would do a movie reaction to gauntlet scene of Mission of Justice. Someone uploaded the film on YouTube. I don't think it's a high def film. I think this film deserves to be remastered, which is a shame. I mean, they put Uncommon Valor on Blu-ray, which that movie does not deserve it, you know. Which I don't care about the film, you know. I more care about this film from Patrick Swayze Roadhouse, which is much better. But this movie deserves to be released on Blu-ray, you know. And of course, I'm just gonna read it. What's the writing on back? Mission of Justice. When it came to cops, Kurt Harris makes the major league. Jeff Wincott, I don't know why I was writing Karate Kid. He wasn't Karate Kid. Makes the major league. With Nerves of Iron and Fists of Steel, martial arts master Harris is the finest in the force. And with what's coming next, he's going to need to be the best. Disillusioned by police politics, Harris hands in his badge and heads off on his own. But when Buddy and boxing champ Cedric is brutally murdered, the one-man war machine sets out on a hurricane campaign to reap revenge. Tracing the case to the sinister Mission of Justice, the Karate Cop finds himself fighting for truth and survival against ruthless Beautai, Rachel Larkin, Bridget Nielsen, a legal vigilante lawman in wrap web of blackmail and betrayal. Mission of Justice, the high power, high stakes thriller with a real kick. The martial arts, I mean, are excellent. This movie, it's a pure badass movie. Mission of Justice is actually my favorite movie. This is my movie. But yeah, that's my movie review on Mission of Justice. I know it's kind of short, but the fight scenes, you know, Cindy Pass, sorry about it. Cindy Pass and Karen Shepard is great fight scene. The parking garage fight scene are terrific. They're excellent. I mean, this movie is just phenomenal. Kick-ass action film. Still, this movie is better. You know, Roadhouse. This movie behind it is much better film. Or even Little Weapons, at least much better film. But yeah, that's my movie review, Mission Justice. Thanks for watching. Thanks for listening and see you next time. I'm out. Peace.